the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Show us, O Lord, your mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Son with the Holy Spirit and made him Christ and Lord, graciously grant that, being made sharers in his consecration, we may bear witness to your redemption in the world through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the lowly, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord and a day of vindication by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion a diadem instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness in place of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a listless spirit. You yourselves shall be named priests of the Lord, ministers of the God you shall be called. I will give them their recompense faithfully, a lasting covenant I will make with them. Their descendants shall be renowned among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall be acknowledged, them as a race the Lord has blessed. The word of the Lord.
Here am I, Lord, I heard you call my name. Reading from the book of Revelation. Grace to you and peace from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead and ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood, who has made us into a kingdom, priests for his God and Father, to him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming amid the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. All the peoples of the earth will lament him. Yes, amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, the one who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went, according to his custom, into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read, and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing. The Gospel of the Lord.
My sisters and brothers, welcome to St. Peter Cathedral for the celebration of the Chrism Mass. I greet those across the diocese who are participating in this Mass by live stream. In particular, I greet you, my brother priest, present for this celebration of the Mass and renewal of our priestly promises. It has been a long time since we've had the opportunity to gather for the Chrism Mass as we do today. All of us, priests, deacons, and their wives, those in consecrated life, seminarians, and lay faithful, offering a powerful witness of the abiding presence of God that alone is capable of overcoming the darkness of suffering and death with life and hope in Christ. Like so many, we have endured more than we could have ever imagined and are here today solely by the grace of God. Reflect with me for just a moment on the past few years that have led to this day. Think back to 2018. We joyfully celebrated the Chrism Mass. That celebration, however, was soon tempered by the release of the Pennsylvania grand jury report later that year. A report that broke our hearts, wounded our spirits, and continued to weigh heavily upon us all as we gathered for the Chrism Mass that followed in April 2019. By the time the calendar turned to 2020, it seemed that there might be hope on the horizon. Life came to a crashing halt around our world with the emergence of the coronavirus. That year, the Chrism Mass was moved to St. Mark Chapel with limited attendance. We had to carve a way forward amid fears, anxieties, and the growing sense of polarization in society and in our church. And while we were once again to celebrate this Mass in 2021, we did so in a limited way that still continued to keep us distant from one another. Finally, as 2022 dawned, we all waited to believe that life would return to what we had known and appreciated a few years ago. But even that simple dream was dashed as unwarranted and unchecked aggression turned into a war in the Ukraine. That unjust conflict and others throughout the world have given us all reason to pause, to confront the reality and the consequences of evil in our world, and to grieve that lives that it has taken. We also grieved at the loss of some of our brothers through death and departure from ministry. I don't recount this recent history of our world and this local church to compound the pain that many of us hold in our hearts. To the contrary, I share our history, our story, to remind us that in spite of all that we have and continue to confront in this broken world of ours, as disciples of Jesus, we do have reason to hope and give thanks this day. In a reflection written about Father Basil Moreau, founder of the Congregation of Holy Cross, the author wrote, quote, "One thing I've learned many years ago was that to be a person who truly lives in hope, it is likely that one has had to live through difficult times. It is also likely that one who sees possibilities of hope in the challenges faced in life have been shaped by many challenges, setbacks, or failures, yet has come through them to be a witness of hope to others." Close quotes. Hold these thoughts in your heart, sisters and brothers. They are essential to understanding the reality of hope in our lives as Christians. In this afternoon's Gospel from St. Luke, the citation from the prophet Isaiah defines the character of Jesus' ministry. Jesus will announce good news to those who are poor, blind, in captivity, and oppressed. But in asserting to the crowds the fulfillment of Isaiah's prophecy, Jesus not only points to himself as the long-awaited hope of Israel, the very prophetic vision of hope that he proclaims for all who are burdened and oppressed because a reality becomes a reality precisely because of his own experience of suffering and pain of his time. In a homily for the World Day of the Poor, Pope Francis offered words that speak providentially to our gathering this afternoon, as he reflected upon two very essential aspects of our lives, today's pain and tomorrow's hope. In acknowledging the reality of today's pain, Pope Francis admitted of a history of our lives, particularly in these days, marked by tribulation, suffering, and injustice, awaiting a liberation that never seems to arrive. He then goes on to note, however, that there is another vital dimension of our lives, tomorrow's hope. Pope Francis tells us, and I quote, "Jesus tells us that even as the sun grows dark and everything around us seems to be falling, he himself is drawing near. Today's hope begins to flower amid today's pain." He continues, "We then, brothers and sisters, are asked to nurture tomorrow's hope by healing today's pain. The two are linked. If you do not work to heal today's pain, it will be hard to have hope for tomorrow. The hope born of the gospel has nothing to do with a passive expectation that things may get better tomorrow, but with making God's promise of salvation concrete today. Christian hope is not the naive, even adolescent optimism of those who hope that things may change, but in the meantime, go on with life. It has nothing to do with building daily by concrete gestures the kingdom of love, justice, and fraternity that Jesus inaugurated. My friends, and especially my brother priests, I implore you, do not let the darkness of these challenging days prevail. Our hope and peace are found in the very midst of the lives we lead and the compassion and mercy that we extend to our suffering brothers and sisters, and they in turn impart to us. Sometimes we can be so overwhelmed by the brokenness of our lives and our world that we underestimate God's power to transform us. Never forget for an instant that God's love can turn everything upside down. Jesus' cross and resurrection are more than proof of this fact. And because of his cross and resurrection, there will never be a time when Jesus will not love and sustain you. In a few moments, oils will be presented: the oil of the sick, the oil of the catechumens, and sacred chrism. These sacramental oils, used to sanctify each of us as faithful members of the Church, are channels of intentional holiness that will be blessed and consecrated in the presence of so many of you, the faithful of this Church, as we, your priest, renew our commitment for that intention. My brother priest, stop and consider for just a moment the hope that you bring to the lives you are blessed to encounter. In addition to sharing the sacramental life of our Church so generously, your presence in and among the lives of the people is far more deeply appreciated than you might ever believe or imagine. In the unique lives that we share as priests, I pray that we come to realize that there is simply no other way to peace and the fulfillment of our hope but through closeness to God and to those lives God has placed within our own. We have made it through a few difficult years, and while the years ahead undoubtedly will bring new challenges, from pastoral planning to one crisis or another, we will make it through those days as well if we are humble enough to surrender to the grace of God and to believe that through the power of the resurrection, God will continue to take care of his people as he always has, including me and you. My brother priest, thank you for your ministry. Thank you for your service and for the witness of your faith. For all of the hope that you have given, the love that you have shared, and the faith in Christ that you have imparted, even while struggling to carry your own crosses, your lives and your ministry are by far the most eloquent homily that can be shared this day. My brother priest, please stand. Beloved sons, are you resolved to renew in the presence of your bishop and God's holy people the promises you once made? Are you resolved to be more united with the Lord Jesus Christ and more closely conformed to him, denying yourselves and confirming those promises about sacred duties toward Christ's church, which prompted by love of him, you willingly and joyfully pledged on the day of your priestly ordination? Are you resolved to be faithful stewards of the mysteries of God in the Holy Eucharist and the other liturgical rites, and to discharge faithfully the sacred office of teaching, following Christ the head and shepherd, not seeking any gain, but moved only by zeal for souls? I now invite all of you to please stand. As for you, dearest sons and daughters, pray for your priests, that the Lord may pour out his gifts abundantly upon them and keep them faithful as ministers of Christ the High Priest, so that they may lead you to him who is the source of salvation. Pray also for me, that I may be faithful to the apostolic office entrusted to me in my lowliness, and that in your midst I may be made day by day a living and more perfect image of Christ, the priest, the good shepherd, the teacher, and the servant of all. May the Lord keep us all in his charity and lead all of us, shepherds and flock, to eternal life. O God, Father of all consolation, who will to heal the infirmities of the weak through your Son, listen favorably to the prayer of faith. Send forth from the heavens, we pray, your Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, upon this oil in all its richness, which you have graciously brought forth from the verdant tree, to restore the body, so that by your holy blessing, everyone anointed with this oil as a safeguard for body, soul, and spirit may be freed from all pain, all infirmities, and all sickness. May your holy oil, O Lord, be blessed by you for our sake. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever. God, strengthen and protection of your people, who have made the oil you created a sign of strength. Graciously bless this oil and give courage to the catechumens, who will be anointed with it, so that receiving divine wisdom and power, they may understand more deeply the gospel of your Christ. They may undertake with a generous heart the labors of the Christian life, and made worthy of adoption as your sons and daughters, they may rejoice to be born anew and to live in your church through Christ our Lord. Let us pray, dear brothers and sisters, to God the Almighty Father, that he bless and sanctify this oil, so that all who are outwardly anointed with it may be inwardly transformed and come to share in eternal salvation. Ask my brother priest to please stand with hands extended. O God, author of the sacraments and bestower of life, we give thanks for your ineffable goodness, for in the ancient covenant you foreshadowed the mystery of sanctifying oil, and in the fullness of time you will that it might shine forth uniquely in your beloved Son. And when your Son, our Lord, had saved the human race through the Paschal mystery, you filled your church with the Holy Spirit and wonderfully endowed her with heavenly gifts, so that through her the work of salvation in the world might be brought to completion. From that time onward, through the sacred mystery of Chrism, you have so bestowed the riches of your grace upon all humanity that your sons and daughters born again in the cleansing waters of baptism, are strengthened by the anointing of the Spirit and conformed to your Christ. They share in his prophetic, priestly, and kingly office. My brother priest, please extend your right hand toward the chrism. Therefore, we beseech you, O Lord, that by the power of your grace, this mingling of fragrance and oil may become for us a sacrament of your blessing. Pour out in abundance the gifts of the Holy Spirit on our brothers and sisters anointed with this oil. Adorn with the splendor of holiness the places and things signed by sacred oils, but above all, by the mystery of this oil, bring to completion the growth of your church until she reaches that measure of fullness in which you, resplendent with eternal light, may be all in all with Christ in the Holy Spirit forever and ever. my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church.
May the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, mercifully wipe away what is old in us and increase in us grace of salvation and newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the New and Eternal Covenant. And by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adored with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they gave up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our day in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Through Christ our Lord. Be pleased, O Lord, O God, your people. We pray to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of eternal salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as you once were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, and the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, commend that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sign of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. And grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, and bless them and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ, keep me safe for eternal life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We beseech you, Almighty God, that those you renew by your sacraments may merit to become the pleasing fragrance of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we depart, just a few expressions of gratitude. To the St. Peter Parish, the rector, Father Michael Farrick, and the parish staff, to Dr. Richard Robert Rossi, cathedral music director, and the instrumentalist and vocalist, to the masters of ceremony and seminarians, to the Gannon University student ambassadors, to the Office for Divine Worship, Deacon Ray and Deb Sabina, the Sisters of the Spiritual Family, The Work, Cheryl Krolzik, who helped with the preparation and distribution of oils. Thank you to one and all. As we prepare to leave this Eucharistic gathering for the 13 counties and 93 parishes, pray that these sacred oils may serve as a sign of our diocesan unity. We are being sent to the sick, to the catechumens, to those to be confirmed, and to those to be ordained. Let us share the gifts of faith and ministry. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Oh.